Welcome to our channel. So this trip from Chennai to Karaikudi was a weekend getaway, and we traveled completely on public transport. So our first bus to Karaikudi was from Coimbatore bus station, and we took a government deluxe bus. And because of the current situation, it was obviously non-AC and it was fairly comfortable. Sorry that this video is a little long, but we suggest you to watch it fully without skipping anything, because we have covered everything that you can do in Karaikudi in 2 days. Hi everyone, so the time is 5:54 and we have just got down at Karaikudi bus stand, or bus stop rather. So we are just figuring out what to do next. We might just stay here for some time and then walk into some good restaurant for breakfast. And we have a check-in around 8 o'clock. Okay, come with us. Looking at multiple ways in which we could while away some time until the restaurants were open for breakfast.
புது பஸ் ஸ்டாண்டுக்கு வந்து இன்னொரு வேற பஸ் வந்ததுன்னா பஸ் ஏறி போகலாம், இல்லாட்டா ஹோட்டலில் ஏறி போகலாம். கொஞ்சம் மூணு மணி
நேரம் அங்கே நல்லா இருக்கா? ஹோட்டலில்
ஹோட்டல்லாம் நான் கேட்கல. ஓ,
அதெல்லாம் கேட்க,
அங்கே போயிட்டு பார்த்துக்கலாம்.
ஹாய் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், இந்த பஸ் ஸ்டாண்ட் நல்லா இல்லையா? சோ மித்தன் விசாரிச்சு வந்துருக்காரு, நம்ம அடுத்த பஸ் ஸ்டாண்ட் போய் சும்மா நிக்க போறோம். ப்ளீஸ் ஜாயின்
பண்ணுங்க. The stop that we got down at Karaikudi did not have many restaurants around, so we took another bus to the new bus stand. We roamed around the bus stop to find out what's there around, and also had tea, coffee or badam milk from the Amul stalls that was there outside. And we actually waited until the Saravanabhavan was open.
How's it? Okay, Shri, tell us, how do you ideally eat idli?
இட்லி ஒரு பீஸ் எடுத்து சாம்பாரில் இப்படி கொடுப்பாட்டி அப்புறம் எல்லா சட்னி மேலையும் தொட்டு சாப்பிடலாம்.
Yummy breakfast, we took a bus to Kanadakathan, and the journey was itself so beautiful with old Tamil classics playing. It really felt like those old Tamil movies. At Chettinad Court, which is just few meters away from the bus stop, so we walked our way to the hotel, and they also let us have an early check-in at no extra cost.
These are the queue list. What all things can be done, and what all this ambience is there.
Kumar, who is the manager here, was so helpful. He suggested to alter our travel plans to ensure we could cover most of the places in the 2 days that we were here. And he also allotted a dual room for us, which was interlinked but still separate. Hi all! So we are at Karaikudi. Lockdown is over. It's not over, but it's relaxed, and that's why we are off for our next trip with all the safety measures. We have our masks on, we have our sanitizers with us, so everything is ready. So we are at Karaikudi. Like you saw, we came by all public transport only because of the prices of petrol right now in India. It's not really feasible to come by our own vehicle, so only public transport. So we are staying here at Chettinad Court. It is a beautiful property. I will definitely take you around this place. But before that, let's start for today's trip. So come with us and enjoy.
Chettinad Court is located in the pretty village of Karnataka Tan. This small, charming 8-room air-conditioned property offers a comfortable stay to its guests. The guests can experience Chettinad hospitality surrounded by the sights and sound of this beautiful village of Karnataka Tan. As the number of rooms are less, staff will fuss over you and fulfill the requirements. Right across the street is the Karnataka Tan Palace, which is also known as the Chettinad Palace. This was built by SRM M. Annamalai Chettiar in 1912. With so many beautiful ornamental details, it took 7 years to complete the construction of the place. This palace exposes the traditional Chettinad architecture. However, they no longer let tourists visit this place due to some disputes within the family.
So this one, right across the Chettinad Court, is the Chettinad Cement Factory owner's house. And a special fact about this is, right opposite to this, there is a school, and the school is specifically for only the children of this family. How cool is that?
These palaces stretch to around 1 acre, and they almost cover a whole stretch of a particular street. In Tamil Nadu, Chettinad houses are found in many places such as Karaikudi, Pallathur, Athangudi and Kothamangalam. These houses are like palaces, having ornamental works throughout the building and woodworks carried out from the wood which was imported, many of them from East Asian countries and Europe.
There's another property of Chettinad Court, which is the Chettinad Mansion. It is a 120-year-old property. This was built in 1908, and it is one of the oldest buildings in Chettinad. So come, let's see what's inside.
Plenty of guests and foreigners who opt to stay here as well. So these rooms are more authentic in nature. A family-friendly, clean and neat resort in an authentic and unchanged heritage palace. The old man sitting here is one of the current owners of this entire palace. Chettinad Mansion is among the largest of the aging 3000 plus mansions spread over 72 villages and 2 towns where the Chettiars live in the area commonly known as Chettinad. The blueprints of the mansion were preserved, and a 6th generation granddaughter has taken pains to put into shape that which is presented here. also seen are some of the original pictures of the early descendants of the family. We were also in awe to know that this white color you see on the walls of the palace is from egg white
or eggshell. We are now at Kiliyarpatti Vinayagar Temple. This is one of the 9 ancestral temples of Chettiars. It is a must visit whenever you visit Karaikudi because this particular temple is considered very powerful.
This is an ancient rock cut temple. Scholars say that Lord Vinayagar is the Lord of Wisdom. Here Lord Vinayagar appears with 2 hands, unlike in other places where he is seen with 4 hands.
Karaikudi is always famous for its beautiful mansions, and the most beautiful among all of them is the Aathangudi Periyavidu. Aathangudi Periyavidu literally means Aathangudi big mansion. So here it is beautiful with its chilly interiors due to the Aathangudi tiles both on the floor as well as on the roof. So let's go and see what's inside.
The Aathangudi Palace is incredibly grand, and it displays the best of the typical features of a Chettiar home. The open courtyards, elaborate veranda, and a gorgeous amalgamation of European and Indian architecture. The stunning mansion has been a location for many Indian films. Japanese styles blend beautifully with the Aathangudi ones, while classy Indian marble enhances the color of these two. The Belgian glass windows create a kaleidoscope of colors on the floor and around the Burma teakwood pillars and doors. It is this whole medley of decor that makes the place grand and very different from other Chettiar houses that I had been seeing. Lavish and ornate would describe the Aathangudi Palace perfectly.
Sanju, what is this place?
This is the dining hall of this mansion. I think around 1,000 people can easily sit here and have their meal together. It's so huge and it has a beautiful echo which makes me want to sing, but just not doing it because video is not really allowed here.
The dining room was almost 50 feet long and very colorful thanks to all the stained glass. One end opened into the reception hall of Aathangudi Periyavidu and the other into the kitchen courtyard.
It is a very interesting place because you can see live making of the tile and you can also try doing one. So let's see how it is.
Ensure you visit this place on a Saturday because Sunday generally these factories are closed. Was that none of these tiles are made in a bulk. Each one of them is handcrafted. A glass mold is lined with a stencil of the chosen design. This is covered with a mixture of cement and oxides. These oxides are decided based on the colors desired in the tile. Hence, in a single piece, one might have multiple colored mixtures. Is covered with Aathangudi sand, but not before removing the stenciled frame. The mold is then curated for 10 days or until the glass plate slips out. Rice husks are used to dry the mix. The tiles can be made in two methods, either with a stencil that will give you a standard output of design or in a freehand drawing method. The one that we are seeing here is a freehand drawing method. While done this way, no two tiles will have the similar design.
ஒரு நாளைக்கு எவ்வளோ டைல்ஸ் பண்ணுவீங்க? நூற்றம்பது ரெண்டு பேர் சேர்ந்து டைல்லாம் என்ன விலையிலேருந்து என்ன விலை இருக்கு? ஸ்கொயர் ஃபீட் கணக்கு
ஆத்தங்குடி டைல்ஸ் ஆர் ஈகோ ஃப்ரெண்ட்லி அண்ட் எக்கனாமிக்கல் அஸ் தே ஆர் கான்ஸ்டிடியூட்டட் ஆஃப் லோக்கலி அவைலபிள் சாண்ட், சிமெண்ட் அண்ட் நேச்சுரலி ஒக்கரிங் ஆக்சைட்ஸ். These tiles are cast by hand and dried over time, so no fuel is burnt during drying or during any other of its processes. After the completion of their demo, they actually let us create a tile of our own with our own creativity, and I totally loved the process of doing this. Right? Let me know how you like this design on the comment section. Next, it was the turn for Shruti. Also showed us how these tiles are detached after completely drying up and arranged to form a beautiful design. sure to cover the Chettinad cuisine by visiting few amazing mess like the Alagar mess here.
Full mail.
Items that you can keep at your home spaces to beautify them. So let's see what's there here. It's true when they say if you want to understand the local culture of a place, you must visit the local markets. I absolutely insist on this for Karaikudi and Chettinad region. In fact, let me rephrase this. If you want to find the treasures that were part of the opulent Chettinad mansions, you must visit the antique market in Karaikudi. In the heart of Karaikudi town, hidden in a single lane, is the unique antique market of Chettinad. This is where you can find a plethora of treasures, from tiny European curios and lamps to elaborate Indian brass and bronze statues. The place is a great shop for anyone looking for the Karaikudi old furniture, the timeless charm of which will amplify your contemporary home. Even if you are not looking for buying, the Karaikudi antique markets will enthrall you to the tales behind its wares. Comes here must visit here and buy sweets and snacks to their home. So let's see how they make it. Unfortunately, the branch that we visited did not have live making of snacks, so we visited another place called Muthukumar Agency. Chettinad sweets and snacks from Karaikudi has won hearts around the world for their crispy and crunchy, mouth-watering, healthy selection of muruks and adirasams.
நீங்க வேற என்னெல்லாம் ஸ்நாக்ஸ் கா பண்ணுவீங்க?
நட்டு போடுவான், மைசூர் பாக் போடுவான், சீப்பிச்சிடை போடுவான், மனவளம் போடுவான், நாகுருண்டை, தட்டை, எந்த ஊர் பா?
சென்னை.
காலையில முறுக்கு அதிரசம் எல்லாம்
முடிச்சுப்பான்.
மதியானத்துக்கு மேல இந்த சீடை சிப்பி சீடை கட்டை இதுக பண்ணுவோம், மாவு உருண்டை இதுக எல்லாரும் சேர்ந்தா தானே பண்ணலாம். தனித்தனியாக விட்டாக்கா சேர முடியாது, நாங்கள் பசி போனாங்களா வெளியே போடுவோம். அதனால
எவ்வளோ வருஷமா
நாங்களாம் ரொம்ப வருஷமா இருக்கோம்.
சாப்பிடுங்க.
ஃப்ரெஷ்ஷாக பண்ண உப்பு சீடை சூப்பரா இருக்கு.
ஸ்ட்ரோ கொடு
சூப். லேசா தேங்காய் தேங்காய் அடுத்த லாக் டவுன் 3.0 வருது. சோ எங்க முறுக்கு கிடைக்கானால நாங்க முறுக்கு வாங்கிப்போம்.
காரைக்குடியில இருந்து முறுக்கு வாங்கிப்போம். பஞ்சத்துல அடிபட்டவங்க மாதிரி.
After all those visits we reached back to the hotel room and we just refreshed ourselves. Now we are going back to the Chettinad mansion for a beautiful candlelight dinner. Come. Actually from the morning itself it is not too sunny, which is why we could cover so many places today, and now it's slightly drizzling, so very beautiful place. The green gates that you see here, all of it are separate car parkings for that palace or the mansion of Chettinad Cements. A beautiful candlelight dinner arranged by the hotel staff. We really enjoyed our food, witnessing the full moon and beautiful courtyard of Chettinad Mansion. Morning, we took some time out to have a beautiful stroll around the streets of Karnadakathan. We saw a beautiful temple pond. We walked across the streets and the markets of Karnadakathan, which was busy with the morning hustle, and it was so colorful and so vibrant in the morning hours. Complimentary breakfast arranged by the Chettinad court at Chettinad Mansion, and we were so flattered with the number of items on our plate, and I totally loved the sweet paniyaram as well. To sit in between the grandeur of Chettinad Mansion's entrance hall and have the best meals was indeed a lifetime experience. There was this beautiful lady who helped us with understanding the Chettinad Mansion's history in great detail, and she also took us to the museum as well, where various antiques were on display. Some of these items are rare and cannot be seen anywhere else in the world. Avid readers or bookworms can escape in the library or hang out at the TV lounge and maybe make friends with other guests at the lounge also. The house with the green gate is called VVR House. True to the locals' words, the watchman happily opened the gates for us. With a minimal charge of donation per person, he allowed us into the threshold of a true Chettinad mansion. That is the size of the main entrance key, and it is as heavy as it looks. A typical Chettiar home extends from one end of the lane to the next. So if you are standing at the main door of the house and the back door is open, then you would be able to see the parallel lane. One of the main characteristics of a Chettinad house architectural design is the presence of courtyards. The rooms are built around these courtyards, termed as Valavil. Locked for several years, the walls of the abandoned mansion seem to be glistening. The reason for this is that all Chettinad homes are made using local limestone mix called kare and eggshells. In fact, this is why this whole area is called Karekudi. These walls can be cleaned and are strong enough to last centuries. A door that separated the tinney or the entrance from the rest of the house was no ordinary portal. Made out of the Burma wood brought by the tradesmen, it told a story of its own. Delicate floral filigree along the door frame could be traced to larger carved splendors in the form of arcs and animals. Stopped by at the best of the best messes, which was the Sri Rangavilas mess. It is a must visit for every tourist. It had mouth-watering food to offer. The next stop of our mansion hopping was at SASRM Heritage Home, and this place was very, very well maintained. It never looked like 150 years old. The owner did tell us that regular shooting happens here, and that's why all the painting and everything was renewed very lately. streets of Karnataka Than, and it's so well maintained, something different from the other mansions that we visited. It's so beautiful and so colorful as well. Come, let's see what's inside. None of the mansions we visited so far allowed us to climb on top. So here you can visit the balcony space here, from where you can see the Mittam directly.
If you are really fond of clicking pictures and a lot of videos and you want a place that is not really full of tourists, then this is where you need to be. Here you will get ample time of your choice and you can click as many pictures as you want. Cotton sarees and other fabrics from here. So let's see how it is done. Since it was a Sunday, we couldn't see a live weaving that was happening, but we could still go ahead and shop sarees.
Where are we now? So we are at Thirumayam Fort, which is surrounded by 40 acres of land.
It was built by the king of Ramnad, and in the history it talks about Veerapandiya Kattaboomman being imprisoned here. So let's see what's there inside.
Originally said to have been a ring fort with 7 concentric walls, of which only 4 are surviving now. The construction of the fort is of inferior quality, as small blocks of stone were used along with the bricks for the building of the fortification. The fort has 3 entrances, one on the north, another on the south, and the third on the east. The shrines dedicated to Hanuman, Shakti, Ganapati, Karupar are noticed on the southern side, and the shrine to Bhairava on the northern side. Halfway to the top on the right side, a chamber which was used as magazine was noticed. Opposite to this chamber on the western slope of a boulder is a rock cut cell containing a linga on Yonipitta, the spout of which is supported by the figure of a dwarf. We also stopped by for an outside view of the famous Ayiram Jannal Veedu, which is the house that has 1000 windows. The house is very famous among the tourists who make it a point to visit the place when in Karaikudi. However, for some unknown reasons, it is no longer allowed for tourists. So that wraps up our trip to Karaikudi. We took our bus back to Chennai. So until we meet next time, do like, share and subscribe to our channel. Bye bye.